Hello everyone, welcome to another video. This is Pascal Maynard recording for Channel Fireball, and this week I'm going to be playing the Mono White Monument deck in Standard. Excuse me. That has been popping out recently in 5-0 leagues, in articles and stuff like that. I talked about it in an article recently. And so this is the kind of deck that pops out in Standard before Hour of Devastation, because Marvel has been banned. This is the kind of deck that would have no chance against Marvel. Like, it plays mid-range creature, it doesn't kill particularly fast, it doesn't have the tool to fight a Marvel at all, or an Ulamog properly. Like, sure, you have these stuff to kill an Ulamog, but their casting trigger is still gonna annihilate you, so this is the kind of deck that you should see more, like these slow mid-range decks that just have like snowballing effects of card advantage, like Oketra's Monument with like Aviary Mechanic, you know, going wide with a bunch of tokens and clues with a Bygone Bishop. So I'm really interested to see how this deck plays out, even though Hour of Devastation is not Magic Online yet, and like it's obviously a disadvantage to testing, but I still want to see how this deck fares against like the old decks. And that's going to give us an opinion on if this deck is playable moving forward. So this is a straightforward list. I literally copied someone's list. I can't recall. Oh, I'm missing a sideboard card here. Let me find out what it is. Sorry about that. I believe it is an Addison. Yep. So there we go. So yeah, it's a list that I copied. Almost everyone's list is very similar. The changes that I've seen are some people play Anointer Priest instead of Aviary Mechanic. I see people play like Sacred Cat and stuff like that. I like this version. It looks very streamlined, so I'm gonna start with that for sure. I don't really have an intent on tuning it until Hour of Devastation actually comes out, because I'm not really testing for an event before Hour of Devastation. It's just really to give me an idea of how this deck plays out. So yeah, the idea here is that we play a bunch of reasonable creatures that have like good commendably triggers or just good effects in general that are more than like just creatures that are meant to attack. So Selfless Spirit, very important in a deck that is trying to go wide because it helps you against sweepers. Same thing with Avacyn. And they actually happen to work well together because you can sacrifice Selfless Spirit to flip Avacyn and get you out of board state with that you're behind. And then we have Hanwer, Militia Captain, another card to take advantage of going wide. If this flips, it gets out of hand really quickly. Another card that takes advantage of going wide is Westvale Abbey. There's four copies. We don't really have a huge cost of playing them, because even though they're colorless lands, because we're just monocolor, which is a big advantage of a deck like that. Aviary Mechanic is super weird. No one would have thought that this was going to be constructed playable, but actually, if you have two of those and an Oketra's Monument for one mana, you can essentially make it 1/1, so it's pretty powerful. And in the deck in general, it's pretty useful as well, because you can bounce your 3-man Inspector, you can bounce some creatures when you have a Bygone Bishop to investigate more. I mean, in worst case, it's a 2-2 for 2, which is not the actual worst. With Faerûn's Warden, you can reset the commendably trigger. It's another creature to bring back with Dusk Dawn. And speaking of Dusk Dawn, I really like the addition of that card in the deck, because it lets you beat decks that have just gigantic creatures. The problem with our deck is that we go wide, but our creatures don't really get big. We just have like a bunch of small dudes, and that's it. So Dusk Dawn is going to clear a board against like Black Rain and Zombies. And the Aftermath part is actually pretty good, because almost all of our creatures have 2 power or less. Then we have 2 cast out as the choice of removal. It could honestly be Declaration of Stone, Stasis Snare, but it looks like cast out was the answer that people decided to play, which makes sense, because like sometimes you'll play against decks where you don't really need a removal and you can cycle it, and it's just a catch-all. It's going to hit almost anything. And then Avacyn, of course, which is really powerful when you cast it on turn 4 with the Oketra's Monument, obviously. And Bygan Bisham is a card we haven't seen play. That card saw almost no play throughout its existence in Standard. But it's actually not a bad card. I think it's been mostly overshadowed by the presence of Stylus Tracker, so people didn't really want to play that card. But this is a flying creature, and yeah, obviously when you investigate and all creatures are cheap because of Oketra's Monument, it is pretty powerful. Sideboard has 4 Gideons. Obviously, we're playing white. We cannot play without Gideon. I think Gideon is probably a little bit worse in the format right now because there's a lot more mid-range like creature decks. And it used to be very good against blue-red, Marvel, and obviously Marvel is gone. Blue-red doesn't see as much play because it was pretty good against Marvel and stuff like that. It's going to be good against like black-green Delirium, but people are playing black-green Snakes. So, yeah, Gideon is still good, but it's mostly a sideboard card at this point against control decks. And or like combo decks like Colossus, for example. Then we have a Fort Fairgrounds Wardern. We had a Fort Avacyn. Fragmentizes, which is going to be good against Colossus. It's going to be good against Mardu. And the rest pretty straightforward. Fumigate for the black-green zombie decks. So I think that's pretty much it. I'm going to be heading into Magic Online League, and I'll see you there. Welcome to round one. We are on the draw, and I believe this is probably a mulligan. I think having two Dust Dawns is pretty loose. It might be easy for it to be just dead, depending on what matchup we're playing against. So I think I'm going to mulligan this hand. If I knew this was going to be good in a matchup, I'd keep this hand, but it's just not the case. All right, this is better. We'll put... interesting. I think we can put that on top. Although I think drawing in basic planes would be much better. Yeah, I'll put that on bottom. But drawing in basic planes would let us go like turn one Inspector, turn two on Militia Captain, turn three Fairgrounds Warden. And it looks like we might be playing against Teemer Energy, which is the most popular deck post bannings. But it might actually not be. Okay, this might be Black Green Energy. My bad. Yeah, I forgot this was going to be... This is the basically second most played deck post-banning. Black-green energy. Swamp into Long Tusk Cub. And we'll play Captain. This comes going to be annoying, so we'll probably have to Fairgrounds Warden it. I could try to double block here, which... wouldn't be the absolute worst. I could actually try that. I don't think they have any sources of energy instant speed. If they do have removal, it's a little annoying. Also not the end of the world. I don't think it's a good game plan for me to try to protect this Militia Captain anyway. So yeah, I'll just double block here. See what happens. I don't mind too much losing this board to like Fatal Push. Alright. This is what's happening. We knew what we got into. Alright, Fragrance Warden. We'll eat the guy. Might have Blossoming Defense. I think he would have played it earlier instead of the push, though. Another hub for a fourth energy. Another cub. Alright, we didn't draw our land. I think I'll play the Captain. Oh, I'll play Mechanic, bounce a land, play Captain. This is another upside of Mechanic. It technically costs you one mana if you like don't have another land, essentially. Yes. Play. I don't know if I crack clue or I play captain. Probably crack clue, actually. Maybe that's wrong. That's annoying. Alright, these guys are going to be very big. Alright, we're gonna have to draw Dusk Dawn. Declaration Stone would be good, but it's obviously not main deck. By obviously, I mean it is not in my main deck. It's not really that obvious. Alright, gains a million energy. Six. Drag this clue. Alright, need to draw land and Dusk Dawn. Alright. Not any of those. Same thing. Pass. The Catcher's Monument would have been a pretty good way of getting out of this. Just making a bunch of 1/1s, blocking forever. I can't even kill any of those cubs. Alright, like I said, double block. This, maybe triple block, or I'd probably die if I do that. Because you can put 6 counters, so yeah, that would kill me, so I guess I block that. That forces him to put a counter on it, and that gives me Dusk Dawn as sort of an answer, but not really, because I'm probably dead next turn. Alright, so he did have Blossoming Defense in his deck, at least. Alright, they're dead. Pulse Board, we want Declaration Stone, Stasis Snare, Faragon's Warden, Fumigate. I don't think Abyssin is that good, they have Grass with Darkness. I think Cast Out is probably just okay. Selfless Spirit seems pretty bad. Especially if they have, like, Walking Ballista. Well, they'll definitely have Walking Ballista. They might even have, like, a Liliana post-board. You have to be careful not to board out too many creatures, though, because we don't want Oketra's Monument to become bad. I think maybe Cast Out is the other card I'm boarding out. Just, like, an expensive removal. Maybe an Avacyn. I do like boarding out Cast Out though, because it's just not one creature. It's just not a creature. Yeah, let's do that. On the play, I'll keep that. Having the cycling hand, the cycling land here helps. Could have played the cycling land on turn one, but I think I'd rather cycle. I don't really want to play mechanic on turn two. Especially since we just drew a land here, I'd rather draw. I already try to draw a monument or a bygone bishop. Doesn't have a second land. Interesting. Get the 7 card hand too. That's weird. Alright, so we'll probably play Inspector. And mechanic, alright, maybe Militia Captain then. Yeah, I'll do that. Not even a push for the Militia Captain. That's weird. Alright, this might have been a misclick or something. Like, he didn't want to keep his hand, he accidentally did. Accidentally did. to keep the same content. It's not like we had a chance to try it. Alright. Okay, I like this hand. We're gonna have to draw lands, but we've got the tools to win the game. Like Dust Dawn, Fumigate, Fairgrounds Warden, to buy time, and then Avacyn. We just need lands, basically. And we have stuff to buy time a little. Alright, one land. That's very good. Constrictor. Ooh, Catcher's Monument. Awesome. Do I play Mechanic here? Probably not. Tutu doesn't really do anything on that board. And we're not going to be racing very much. It's just going to be a... We're going to be the control, essentially. The control guy. Rather keep this Mechanic for Oketra's Monument. Ballista for two. Alright. I could play Monument or play Fairgrounds Warden and eat, like, the Ballista or the Constrictor. Probably Ballista. But I think I'll just play Oketra's Monument. Might have been wrong though, because if I do play Fairgrounds Warden and eat Ballista, he's just gonna eat the tokens with the Ballista. I don't know, not exactly sure. I guess I'll Deckenstone the Ballista and then play Fairgrounds Warden. Or, actually, it might be way better to Fragrance Warden than Ballista. That lets me... Fragrance Warden to Ballista means it's going to come back and die. Even if he kills my Warden. That's actually pretty good with Fumigate or Dust Dawn in my hand. Yeah, let's start by doing that. Oh yeah, this was dumb. This is a commutable effect, which means he can kill my Fairgrounds Warden and my warrior. This is not like a cast trigger. Yeah, that makes sense. Should definitely be doing that. Was my play bad then? No, I don't think so. I think it's probably still fine. So, I don't know if I Deckenstone or I play Mechanic here. The problem is I don't really want to bounce anything. Could bounce a land, but if I do bounce a land, I can't fumigate next turn. But I guess it's not really a big deal. I don't have to fumigate next turn. Yeah, I'll do that. Alright, pass. I think I might double block here. Not 100% sure if I double block. Now I'll just play Avacyn next turn. Play Avacyn and, like, gang block something. Alright, well, now we're going to attack with those. So if he didn't play anything there, he definitely has a bunch of removal in hand. still play Addison. Grasp Darkness. So I could play Avizen in response, and my Avizen will flip on his turn. Killing the Constrictor. It's close to the same thing as ambushing it. Except... because I don't really... I don't give him a draw step to draw, like... another grasp. I'll lose my two warriors in the process, but I get to have a 6/5 Avacyn instead of a 4/4/1. Yeah, I like that. Just hope he doesn't have another grasp, but then in that case, it's just the same thing, right? Like, I can't really stop the second grasp anyway, so might as well force him to have it during his upkeep. It also leaves him to zero energy. If he casts another grasp during his upkeep. Alright, that's fine. Take 2, down to 8. Long Toss Cub. Interesting spot. I don't really want to fumigate in this spot. I think playing Inspector in Cracking the Clue is my... it's the first I'm going to do and evaluate. I don't really want a deck in stone. I can easily wait. Hopefully he plays Rishkar or something and I can dust down. Combat. Go like this. If he has Blossoming Defense. Alright, something like this. Sure. Let's try that. Alright. Does he have another one? Fatal Push as well. Okay. Alright, then I guess I'll fumigate. Fumigate. I wish I could dust because I actually want to play Dawn. Let's fumigate. Probably gonna have to cast that into the dark. Start casting this. Turn this. Play it. Cast this. Cast this. Blank. And then we can cast it for 5 and return another mechanic and basically go off. It's pretty sweet. Has a 3/4.
play that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Play that. I guess I should have played Fairground's Warden. Yeah, that was kind of stupid. Oh well.
I got excited there for a minute. The amount of removal that I have in my hand, I should have probably not even have done that. But again, I also have a million 1/1s because of mechanic. And I win the match. Yeah, well, this game played out well for us. We didn't get to his draw wasn't that good, but honestly, if it would have been better, maybe our Dostan would have done something. So I don't know if it's like a good thing for us or not. But he did draw like a removal heavy hand, and that just did not work out against our deck, our game plan at least post board. Welcome to round 2, and we're on the draw. Our opponent mulliganed to 6. Our hand is a little weird. I don't know if we can actually mulligan any hand that doesn't have a 2-drop in it. I kind of feel like this is a mulligan. Well, I don't think I don't think it's because it doesn't have a 2-drop, but I think it's because it doesn't have monument in it. Like, I think if you don't have a 2-drop or a monument, or like maybe if I had like Faragon's Warden and cast out an Avacyn or something. But the fact that I have Bishop, I feel like this hand is really slow, basically. So I'm gonna mulligan it. Alright, well, this is awkward. I think on 6 cards on the draw, we have to keep this hand. It's not like our deck cannot use all the lands. It is pretty good at mana sinking because of the clues. So I think Phylon is not the actual worst. I basically don't really want to go to 5 cards. So I'm gonna keep it and hope to draw spells. Alright, I'll take that. It's a good turn 1 play. Botanical Sanctum. Again, I'm thinking Temur Energy. Alright, not a second land drop. I'm getting a lot of free wins here. Alright, that might be very quick. If he doesn't have Harness Lightning there. Alright, well, I'm sorry about that. I didn't mean to not have games like that. Like last round, our opponent scooped on turn 3 or whatever of game 2. For the same kind of reason, didn't have like another land. Well, we don't really know what he's playing. I would guess that he's Temur Energy. If he's Temur Energy... Not even sure how I'm sideboarding. I guess I want this Avacyn. I guess I probably want less Dostan, at least one less. It kills like Bristling Hydra and Glorybringer, but Avacyn is very, very good against Glorybringer. So I definitely want an Avacyn. Selfless Spirit might not be the best card ever, although it'll probably have Sweltering Suns postboard. But that can be managed with Avacyn. I could see boarding out like 2 of those. I think Stasis Snare is probably better than cast out. They don't really have Planeswalkers. I guess that's not true. They actually have Chandra. But Chandra is not that good against us because we go wide. Yeah. I would not be surprised if they boarded out Chandra, actually. It's pretty bad against like a Oketra's Monument. So I'll board out cast out. Do I want another Faragon's Warden? It's pretty bad against Glorybringer.
I'll try it like that. These could be boarded out easily. Not sure what I want instead, though. Maybe it's the cast outs or it's the Fairground Warden. Maybe a Fumigate. Like on the draw against Bristling Hydras. Although, again, Bristling Hydra is pretty bad against Oketra's Monument. Yeah, it seems like Sweltering Suns will be the best card against me, so I'll keep those Selfish Spirits. Alright, we'll keep this. I'm not gonna play a cycling land because we want to cycle it. We already have four lands. Play the Selfless Spirit. He attacks me. I feel like I want to block. It probably means he has another servant, honestly. Yeah, I guess I take it. With Unaware Militia Captain, I guess I'm going to try to flip it. And then I want many creatures in play. Oh no, I have sixed. Whoops, that was my bad. I clicked F6, and because of that, he's able to just deal one to it instead of me sacrificing it and him not gaining any energy. So, my bad. Sorry about that. I'm not gonna F6 now. For those who don't know, F6 means, it basically, like, my opponent can do anything and I'm not going to click anything. It's usually a good way to save some clicks, because like whenever there's a trigger I have to press OK. And when you have nothing to do, you press F6 so that you don't have to do all these OK clicks. But I didn't think of Harness Lightning targeting my Selfless Spirit. Just taking that, I guess. I'm gonna have to deal with this Glorybringer. Could cycle one of those farmlands. I do still have a little bit of time, so I'm gonna attack with this and pass. If he exerts to kill something, then, you know, it's one turn and he's not attacking with the Glorybringer, so it's not too bad. I'll take it. Or is it? No, it's too late. But I don't know, maybe it's not a plan at all to try to flip those captains. Possible that I should not have. I should have blocked the servant. Alright, well, I'm going to cycle that. Hopefully find an answer to the Glorybringer. Nope, just more lands. I'll attack with that. All right, we'll sack it now. Oh, I just realized I don't have to bounce something. It really, like, obviously I knew that. I for some reason, match one, I basically bounced one of my land when I clearly didn't have to. And now, obviously I don't have to, so I'm not doing it. But it's weird because it literally asked me, do you want to do it or not? And for some reason, I still clicked OK to bounce one of my lands game match one when it was clearly bad to bounce a land. But I knew that because I played, I did play Kaldish Limited. I had like 25 of those in my account. All right, we're dead. Okay, so
It is team or energy. I don't know if I'm supposed to have more answers to the Glorybringers. I didn't draw Avacyn, so. Maybe Dawsdawn is just bad and I want cast outs. Let's try that. It's a much better answer to Glorybringer. And if I'm correct, I think. If I'm correct, I think that he would board out Bristling Hydra. Alright, for game 3, we are going to be on the play. This is tempting to keep. Because we have the monument. We have a cast out that we can cycle. Nah, that's probably mulligan. I think maybe on the draw it's a keep. Alright. Keep, please monument on top. Oh, called shot. There you go. Alright, the classic turn one attune. Then I think we'll play one of the mechanics. I mean, unless it dies, it's pretty much free. I don't think he's gonna kill it. And it's just like, if he doesn't have a threat on turn two, I can get in for two damages. Oh, attack with Inspector first, and actually bounce the Inspector. Spire Bluff Canal. I feel like the games where I'm going to draw Monument versus the games I'm not drawing Monument, there's going to be huge win percentage disparity. Take two. Play Monument. Pass. Rub Refiner, and that's when we're going off. I guess the Abbeys are a little annoying here because we needed a bunch of white for those mechanics. Play Bishop and like. Play Inspector or crack the clue. I think maybe I cracked a clue. Yeah, I'll crack the clue. It's a better use of my mana, I think, and I just want to get a bunch of lands essentially. Another Refiner. I do not mind playing this game. I think I'm winning this kind of game. I'm gonna have to draw Avacyn though, because Glorybringer is gonna be scary. Alright, well, this is an issue with the deck, is that double Oketra's Monument doesn't really do anything. But I think it's not that big of a problem, since the first one is good enough, usually. I'll attack. I'll play. Selfless Spirit. I'll crack the clue. I'll play Spectre. Mechanic. return another mechanic. Attack for two. Pass. And then we can Wesvel IB, and I don't think they'll have many answers to that. They can Confiscation Coup, I guess. It would make some sense for them to have Confiscation Coup in their deck, because stealing Oketra's Monument sounds kind of cool. That is fine. It's exerted. We've cast out. So we didn't draw a land for Abby yet, but some time to do that. I kind of want to crack a clue here. I really want to find a land. Fairgrounds Warden is not bad either. I don't want a Fairgrounds Warden just now, because if I do and he kills my Fairgrounds Warden, he gets to attack with Glorybringer again. I'm cracking another clue. Alright, we found a land. I'm gonna attack with this. One of those. Bounce this, replay it, and pass. So I'm trying to think here, if my opponent has, oh, buck, why is this attack happening? Oh, maybe Sweltering Suns? Yeah, Radiant Flames. Okay. What do we do here? I'm really scared of Fairgrounds Wardening that Glorybringer. I'm gonna have 5, 6, 7, so I can cast Fairgrounds Warden and like pass with 4 mana up, right? Yeah. Yeah, I'll just play that, bounce nothing. And if he plays another Glorybringer, or if he plays in a Harness Lightning, I can still cast out whatever Glorybringer that's going to be in play. But yeah, I was thinking, if he gets Confiscation Coup my Ormondal, and I cast out, and then I later cast out my cast out, do I get the Ormondal back? Because it doesn't say owner. It says exile target non-player and opponent controls until cast out leaves the battlefield. Druid's Deliverance. Yep, that's fine. I have another in hand. So this says the same thing. So yeah, I would think that it would get it back, actually, and I don't get it back. It's not worded the same way it used to be. It doesn't say owner's control. Tune. Mountain. Alright, so we get the double clue. Then Monument. Bishop. I'll crack a clue main phase. and pass. I could trade this mechanic for the refiner so that I can start attacking with the warriors, but I also kind of want to keep the mechanic around in case I draw another one. God! Are we gonna lose this game for real? God damn it. Guess this is sort of happening. Another one. Oh my god. Okay, well, I can deal with both. But are we going to be able to win this game? Take three. Alright, Selfless Spirit it is. Can make a 1-1 with Dazvel Abbey. Man, drawing Avacyn in any of those turns would have been so good. So I'll kill this and chop this. One pass. Chomp again. Damn it. Yep, one turn. To life. Wow. Stop with the lands. I needed those lands earlier. Not now. Now we can't even make two abbeys. We have the mana for it, but we can't because we're at two life. There we go. It's a little late to the party, but I'll take it. I'm guessing he has Arnis Landing by now, though. Guess it's time to jam the Avacyn. Is another one. Yeah, that's fine. At least we still protect the other one. So we can block for two more turns. Tracker is a very good card. Oops, I floated an extra mana. probably gonna lose to that tracker, honestly. If he draws a Virtuoso, we are crazy dead. Magma Spray to 2/2. Activate Lumbering Falls. Oh, Chandra. Wow. Okay. That gets us dead. Yep. He got it. Damn. We were not getting there. Alright, I'll see you next round. Alright, round 3 here on the play. We are going to keep this. So far, not drawing Monument has felt pretty bad. We lost that last game, but I don't know if I did something wrong. I think not drawing Avacyn early was a huge reason to why we lost. We would never lost to those sweepers, essentially. But it is what it is. But yeah, I felt like not drawing Monument has been harsh. Oh, it looks like we might be playing a mirror match. I'll play Bygan Bishop in this spot. Attack. Catcher's Monument. Alright, let's see what happens in a matchup where he has it and I don't have it. Okay, Fairgrounds War in this guy. I think I'll play that and Inspector. Force him to have something to not flip my Captain. Shop. Alright, no Avacyn. This turn at least. Selfless Spirit. He has flyers. So we can't really win in the air. But once this flips, it's going to be pretty big and making a 1-1 every turn. It's probably not going to be enough. He's also going to flip his, so I'll probably have to eat it with that. Mechanic. Not bouncing anything, probably. Or maybe it will bounce like Sylphus Spirit. Depends what he has in hand. If he has more juice, then he probably don't bounce anything. He bounced land. Interesting. I think he may have made the same mistake as we did before. So I guess I'm just casting Faragon's Warden on the Militia Captain. Wait, how do I even get out of this? I guess I need Avacyn. I need Avacyn to flip, so I need to kill the Selfless Spirit at some point. Do I need to just kill the Selfless Spirit now and just ignore the Militia Captain? I think that's probably what I have to do. Like, I can already not beat Monument. Like, adding Militia Captain doesn't really matter. I just need to find Avacyn no matter what. So I'll eat that Selfless Spirit. And pass.
pass, I guess.
Could have considered attacking with this guy. To either eat a warrior or like have him block a bunch of things. Block with a bunch of things so he can't flip, but I don't know, I think it's probably better to sit and just wait until they draw Avacyn. Alright, that's fair. We'll chump this guy. Sure. I don't think Westfall Abbey is a way for me to win the game. They can draw Farragon's Warden, and I don't know, I think because of that they'll have like a way too big board for me to deal with. Crack a clue. Alright, that's a sort of. Maybe we can compete. Spectre's gonna have to chomp that Westvale cult leader. Then we'll eat one of those, and like this. Come on, Avacyn. Yoo-hoo! Got there. Now I could play mechanic to bounce the bishop to my hand so I can save it. Or is it better to just have the mechanic in my hand? Yeah, it's probably better to have the mechanic in my hand than the bishop. I already have three clues and another bishop in my hand. So yeah, I'll go to combat and just second main phase Avacyn. Go. This guy. And pray. Fortunately, he's going to get his own Selfless Spirit once that Avacyn flips. But there's not much we can do about that. please. No, cast out. All of our efforts. Oh, that's even worse. Or is it actually? Yeah, I guess it is. We lose our blockers and we take a million. Have to block like the big guy and I take a million and I don't really have an out. Alright. Well, we want fragmentize because it deals with Oketra's monument. It deals with cast out. Cast out is good because it deals with monument and it deals with Avacyn, which are two of the most important cards. We want Fort Avacyn. We want Selfless Spirit to protect from Avacyn. I think Dawn is pretty bad. Fairgrounds Warden is probably mediocre. Yeah, it's pretty mediocre, I think. It deals with Selfless Spirit, but it's pretty much it. Is Declaration of Stone good because I can exile all of his tokens? It's honestly probably not even good enough. Like, they can make a million every turn. Fumigate, since I'm awful against Avacyn and Selfless Spirit. So, like, those are considerations. I think Stasis Nair is not really a consideration because we already have Cast Out, which deals with Monument. So, something like that. And then I have to board out two cards. Maybe those Fairground Wardens are just not very good. Either keep one or keep a Stasis Snare. Yeah, I'll have a Stasis Snare there. Ever having another answer to Avacyn, probably pretty important. Alright, we're on the play. And we're gonna keep this. We have Monument, so we can't say no to that. We have Fragmentize, so an answer to theirs. We have Selfless Spirit to protect ourselves from Avacyn. This actually seems like a pretty complex mirror match. Well, not kind of complex, but I think once both players like know that Monument is so important, it becomes sort of like, you know, there's multiple levels. The first one is to have Monument, second is to deal with their Monument, then it's if you're behind it's Avacyn, then you want Selfless Spirit, then you want answers to Avacyn. There's just like many things going on. It's pretty interesting actually.
It's possible that cards like Hunwear, Militia Captain should be boarded out because it like doesn't really do anything in either of these plans, but I'm sure it's very good if none of the players have Monument though. Alright, we drew the land. So now I clearly don't want to trade my Selfless Spirit because I'm the person who has a Monument, so I want to protect my board from Avacyn. Alright, he doesn't have it. Doesn't have his own monument. Play mechanic. We'll bounce a land. Again, and we'll pass turn. Now we essentially just want lands. Alright, another Bygone Bishop. Got no problem with that. I really don't want to cycle cast out, because that's going to be one of our answers to Avacyn. Two here, no problem. Alright, we'll play our own Bygone Bishop to stop some of the bleeding. Mechanic. Bounce a land. Oh, actually, we can't bounce a land here. Yeah, we can't bounce a land. Because we don't want to stop the loop. Seem to have a good attack here. Alright, we'd like to find a land here. I'm very tempted to crack this clue. Alright, we found a land. This play this. Bounce this and pass turn. We'll probably be able to start attacking like next turn. No, not even Avacyn here. Fragmentize is fine. We have another monument. Zone. No problem with that. I'll probably bounce the inspector. Replay it for a total of 9 clues. Play monument. I guess I could have played second main phase. Attack with this. Just this for now. And pass.
Will this game ever end? Just casually have 2 14-14s. Let's see what a clue gives us. Nick. Plit. That was kind of bad. I should have attacked first to keep cast out. I didn't realize he had 5 mana up, so he can have us in. Oh well. Now, do I even attack with this cult leaders? Because if he has Avacyn, that's 10. It would be able to kill one of them. Yeah, there's no point. I'll just attack next turn. This is such a weird game. I'm not sure if I should be popping a Wesva Abbey. I don't think so. He has a cast out, and he looks like he kept Fairground's Warden, so yeah, definitely don't want to do that then. Sense. Yeah, I don't sack in response because I'm gonna be able to just kill the warden to get it back. Two cast outs now. Alright, we'll make some attacks. Like that. Alright. Damage. It's down to 10. Play a mechanic. I'll keep 4 mana up just in case I have to double cast out. Really don't need to do anything else, so might as well. Well, that's a little bit late. I'll just count, but I think we have lethal. All right, so we have 4, 5, 6, 7, 14 1-1s. He has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 creatures. So he's using 4 to block my big ones. So he has 5 left. So we're actually 1 short. Is this what's happening? So I should have cast the cast out here. And I would have won. I guess I still win. It was just more optimal to kill the Westvale cult leader before damage, but I guess I can just take out this warden. I get a 2-1. And I take out one of his creatures, and it should be enough. With 4 mana, I don't think he can punish me for doing this. And we send a team. I guess. Yeah, hopefully I didn't miscount. Because him playing Avacyn could be somewhat of a disaster. So he gets a 1-1. I'm just going to make sure. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 that he has to block. So 5 more. He takes 9? Alright. So if I cast out again, he's exactly dead. Yeah, he's exactly dead. Exactly 10 get in. And it does it. Alright, well, that was kind of a crazy game. But we had Monument and he didn't. Do I want to change anything? I still think that Fairground's Ward is not that good here. Yeah, keep the same thing. Maybe Unwary Militia Captain is a card that I can board out. But I want to see what the games look like when both players don't have a Catcher's Monument. Because of like cast outs and fragmentized, then maybe the Militia Captain is just a big game. Because it's sort of like another monument. Alright, well, we're going to keep this. You've got Fragmentize, Avacyn, just mostly all the pieces. A little bit of awkward mana, but it should be fine. I have to play this. Selfless Spirit. Alright, another monument to be protected from fragmentize or cast out. Take 2. I wish I had enough of those planes. But I don't even know how to find those on Magic Online. No wagon bishop, no monument. All right, cast out. I can fragmentize his cast out, but I'll probably play Inspector and play Monument instead. Keep the fragmentized for is monument. 2. Another selfless spirit. Fairgrounds Warden. Take out the mechanic. Well, that was smart because we just drew another one. I think I'd probably play mechanic, bounce a land, replay it, pass. Yeah, that seems good. Since we're stuck on mana, on white mana, I think that was probably the best use of my lands. I think that he has an answer here, or even his own Avacyn. Sort. Okay, Dickenstone. And Militia Captain. Alright, we'll start off with cracking a clue. Crack another clue. Cast Selfless Spirit. And pass turn. I can Abby next turn. I think with no cards in hand, it's probably reasonable. Oh, or I can cast out the Fairgrounds Warden. Cast out the Fairgrounds Warden. Mechanic comes into play. Bounce a mechanic. Yeah, probably better to make a gigantic creature. That's five, right? Five. Alright, he didn't block. That's great, because then we can cast out the Selfless Spirit next turn, that's lethal. Sure, we'll take four. Alright, double block? Maybe a double block. I could be punished if he has like his own gas out or something, but I'm willing to potentially lose to that. Guess he could have Avacyn also. Oh, I'm so stupid. He has five creatures. Oh my god. I am so stupid. Actually, it's not bad. Because I can bounce this ghast out of my hand. Okay. Yeah, that wasn't so bad. I can block and sack the selfless spirit so he doesn't gain life. Or, well, I guess it's too late. But he would have gained 9, so up to 15. I would have attacked for exactly 15, so I guess I didn't have to block. I guess that's too late. Well, I've not been playing this game very well.
But we still win it, I guess. Alright. We'll be on the play for this round 4. Keep this hand. Doesn't have monument, but we have an inspector, a mechanic to buy it. Alright. Pass. Zombies? Looks like we're playing as zombies. I'm gonna get some DOS Dawn action. I don't know if I'm supposed to crack clue here to find monument. Maybe not. Maybe I just play militia captain, and if I draw an entrapment inspector, then I can flip. I don't know what's better. I think it's probably better to add to the board than trying to find a monument there. We'll bounce to the three bin. Pass. Discard Scrounger. Main deck Scrounger and Zombies. Interesting. Oh, red black. Our team did try a red black version of Zombies for the Pro Tour, and we were basically splashing for cut. Cathartic Green. Okay, this is actually not Zombies. This is probably like a. Well, this is the old version of Zombies, so it's essentially a prize amalgam deck, I think. Well, we drew Monument here. So Dazdan's not going to be that good against them. We're not as good. Yeah, we'll bounce this. And pass. Another Cathartic Reunion. Discarding Hunted Dead. Fatal Push the Captain. Alright, we can make a lot of guys. And do I just want to do that? Probably. Crack a clue instead of making a token. Try that. I think Westville Abbey is going to be a game-winning thing to do. We'll try to Abbey next turn. And see what happens. I don't think they have a good answer to that. So the double aviary mechanic thing has been happening a lot more than I would think. So I think this might be the best two drop to play instead of like Anointer Priest and stuff like that. All right. What happens if I have a gigantic creature? Are you dead? Hopefully it doesn't have something like to the slother or something like that. Cut Ribbons is a pretty nice addition to this deck, actually. Like a reasonable removal, and the aftermath is pretty sweet in a deck that sort of like mills itself. Doesn't actually mill itself, but discards a lot of cards. You can block with Haunted Dead. Can't really block forever unless he has a way to sacrifice the Haunted Dead, though. Attack. Bring back Haunted Dead. With two prized Amalgam. It's powerful, but not enough. We have way too much life. I'll try this mechanic thing. At this point, even if he deals with the Abbey, we can make another one. Can't have two in play at the same time though, because they are legendary. And we'll keep two mana, crack a clue.
Fair enough. We're not blocking Haunted Dead. Not blocking anything, in fact. Hard cast Haunted Dead. Nope. Crack this clue. We can attack with the warriors here. I think so. Voldaren Paria. That's an answer to Armindal. Haven't seen this card in a while. Sacrifice three other creatures and then transform it. Okay, well, he's gonna have to block this turn. Okay, I guess I have to be careful of that next turn, next time. And he puts Antidote in the graveyard so he can actually block again. The following turn. It's fine. That's a lot of clicks. It's pretty annoying. Yeah, I think if I'm careful, it's pretty easy to play around Fold Air and Peria. And my deck. Alright, so he drew a card with Cryptbreaker, and let's see what happens from there. He's clearly blocking again with Hunted Dead. Make a bunch of 1-1s again in case a bunch of my warriors die in combat, and somehow my aviary mechanic dies as well because of like a remove, like a paria. That should be enough. I can sack the warriors, they're not attacking. Fiery Temper. Interesting. That's gonna kill one of the mechanic, that's fine. We can Dost on to bring back more mechanics. Don't have to use it. Stack with those. Hunted Dead, do not die. Discard a Lightning Axe in the innate. He's gonna have to eventually die to those 1-1s. Cast that. Just so that we have it in the graveyard and we can aftermath. There's like no point to attack with the warriors. Not this turn, at least. God damn it, it's never gonna end. All right, this happens. Zombie, he blocks, and then sacrifice prized amalgam, Hunted Dead, probably. Draw a card, he's down to 2 life. Draw another card, down to 1 life. Transform.
Southern Peria. Sacrifice three creatures. Then 5, cast Dawn. And he concedes. Thank God. Now, post sideboard, we probably want Declaration in Stone. Exiling creatures seems good. I think Cast Out is probably not that good because it's a little slow. Fairgrounds Warden's probably reasonable, but not that great because they have Fiery Temper. Stay Snare probably okay. I don't think Gideon is very good. Maybe it is like on the play. Probably not though. So we want these. I think Dawn's pretty bad. So we could do like that. And then those cast out could be. I think Avacyn is reasonably good, but not unbelievable. So yeah, let's replace those cast outs for Stasis Snares. I don't think there's like a non-impermanent that I want to hit is the thing. So I think I'd rather have a 3 mana removal than a 4 mana removal. That cycles. Alright. He mulliganed, and we have this hand. We're going to mulligan this as well. And keep. Monument. Cannot say to this hand. Put that on bottom. We want a land. Go, found a land. So I don't know if I'm gonna deck and stone something here. Maybe I deck and stone that Cryptbreaker. It's fairly important to our game plan. I think the ideal plan is to deck and stone prized amalgams, but if he's no way to discard them, it might not be very good. I know Cryptbreaker is a way that it can easily snowball into beating my monument. Discard Hunted Dead, no third land. Monument, pass. Cracked his clue. Alright. Let's get the party started. Gonna play Mechanic. Plains, play it, play that, and pass. We certainly got lucky last game that when we abbeyed, it didn't have Peria. I think we would have still won because like we just made so many tokens that we would have been able to do it again. But I don't know, I think there was an actual chance that we lose, whereas now there's just no way we could have lost. Like after. Fiery Temper, kill the Bishop, probably. Get an Amalgam in play. We have another Bishop. I can attack here. I think I play Bishop instead of cracking a clue. Maybe not. I kind of want to just draw land. Ugh, that was the worst draw. Maybe this was wrong, but I really wanted to get this other land so that we can Avacyn. And obviously getting a land would have been insane because we can cast that. Maybe this was wrong. Alright, we got there. Don't want to play Avacyn yet. Just play Bishop, crack a clue end of turn. I don't want to play Avacyn because of like how, because it didn't do anything there.
Don't want it to get lightning axed. That's fine. Spent on that thing especially. Crack clue. I'll pass, end of turn play absent. Could have attacked to get some damages in, but I don't really want this Haunted Dead to die. Because if it does, then you can bring back Bride's Amalgam, discard some cards, do things. That's fine. Can Abby sacrifice tokens? Blocks it, takes six. Absinthe's gonna flip. We'll just sack the Selfless Spirit. Actually, I didn't really want this Avacyn to flip, because now we can bring back Haunted Dead. No, maybe this was wrong. Do I sack it? He's gonna get a zombie. Yeah, I guess he's gonna get too many zombies otherwise. And now Voldaren Peria is like really good. Okay, this was clearly wrong. Oh, it's not true because my board doesn't die. Okay. Yeah, yeah. Makes more sense. Well, it looks like he's passing. So I can still Lightning Axe my Avacyn and then block Ormondal with a token. Probably just attack with the Flyers. Temper. Oh, he has two Haunted Dead. So we counted it twice. And block. This Karnak can't repair it, but he can't madness it. So many triggers. We're up to 35. And win the match. All right, I'll see you next round. Maybe we can 4-1 this league. Welcome to round 5. We are currently 3-1. We're trying to fight to get some chests. And our opponent mulliganed. We're going to keep this. This hand is not particularly insane, but we have technically like 3 redraws. We have a clue. We can cycle this. We can cycle this. We have even mechanic to rebody the inspector. So, this hand has a lot of velocity. Alright, looks like we're facing our opponent multi 6 and he's right on top. And some red green deck. Maybe a red green energy, maybe teamer energy. That's what I'm thinking of. Other hub and servant. So I think we'll play Selfless Spirit here and not mechanic. I don't mind, like, I could play mechanic so that I can rebuy an inspector. But I really don't need to do that now. I can just crack the clue that I have in play instead. Combat. Alright, he offers a trade. It is somewhat interesting. I don't think Selfless Spirit is super necessary game one, because they'll likely won't have Sweltering Suns or Raiden Flames. But on the other hand, if he wants to trade, it's probably because he doesn't need that servant, but we don't really need that Selfless Spirit either. Like, yeah, I'll block. I think if I had Militia Captain or something in my hand, I wouldn't block, but I think this is fine. It is weird that, like, I think as long as you don't have Monument, you really just want to buy time. Like, you never want to race, really, because you're not going to go into race. I just need a monument to win the game, so I do not mind trading like that. Another servant. That was sort of expected. And not a third land. Interesting. Meanwhile, we are drawing lands. I think I'll play mechanic, bounce the inspector, and next turn crack 2 clues. I think that's the best use of my mana, most efficient. Alright, looks like we're playing against Red Green Pummeler and not Teamer Energy. I would think that this is not a good matchup. We don't have a lot of instant speed removal. I kind of want to just play that cast out now on this Pommeler. I don't want him to have Blossoming defense up, so yeah, I'll do that. And I will attack with both of my creatures. I said that I would rather trade and race, but I think that if I keep the mechanic, I mean, he's likely going to use the servant for mana anyway, so might as well just get in for two, then keep it as a blocker that's not really going to block. First thing, Hydra. Alright, well, we'll start by cracking a clue. Then play Inspector, and then crack another clue end of turn. Alright, so I don't know if we take this or not. I guess I'm at 20 life. I don't think I'll die. Can pump it 3 times. It'll be up to 7 power. You could uncage Fury plus something, and that would kill me. I guess I'll jump. Like, just pretty likely I die. I think the only thing that gives trample though is Invigorated Rampage, and maybe Larger Than Life that they were playing. I'll take Brawler, has trample on its own. Another Voltaic Brawler. And we'll crack a clue. That's a lot of 3-man Inspectors. You know what would be good? Dos Dawn. Come on. Bayan Bishop. Man, not the worst. Do I even want to play it? I can play an Inspector. I think it's better to play Inspector, crack a clue, and then next turn cycle. That just gives me the most draw. The most draw steps, basically. The most draw steps for next turn to find Dawson. Doesn't give me the most, it's not the most efficient way to spend my mana overall, but to spend my number of clues, I mean, but I think I need to hit it by next turn or something, or maybe not. Maybe I have more than one turn, but in any case, my line was that I think that I have to Dos Dawn next turn, otherwise I'll die. Alright, so this is coming at me. I'll probably double block the servant. And maybe I can double block a brawler. If I take it, that's 8 plus 4, 12. And then you can pump 3 times. You can deal 15. Yeah, I'll block like that. Or maybe I don't block the Bristling Hydra, and I just Avacyn next turn. Try to set up something reasonable. Alright, he has Invigorated Rampage. That doesn't kill me, though. Down a 6. Alright, so he did a split of Invigorated Rampage. He targeted this and this so that the Servant kills my 2 Inspector. So now I can't really, like, Avacyn that profitably. Can I even Avacyn? I'll start by drawing a card. Come on, Dust On. If I Avacyn, I block Brawler and Hydra and go to 1. Guess I'll do that. Tune is fine. And then 2 life. Play Avacyn. Put the mechanic on the Hydra. Get to kill a brawler. It might actually not be that bad if he doesn't draw a pump spell. Because I get to play Bishop and then another Avacyn. Let me make sure. If I play Bishop and Avacyn, I can put Avacyn on. I can put Avacyn and Mechanic on the Hydra and the Bishop on the Brawler and go down to 1 life because of Trample. And then I get to kill the Hydra. Seems good. I don't get to kill the Brawler, but I can deal with that later. Fine. Go to blocks. Those are my blocks. Hopefully, if he has Harness Lightning or something, he plays it now. But he's not. So we just play this Avacyn to give our board indestructible. We keep the one that's blocking. Go to one life. Another brawler. Alright, that's gonna make things complicated. Trample is annoying. Flipping Avacyn would be good, sort of, because it would kill those two brawlers and kill him pretty quickly. Alright, well, that's a light monument. Let's cycle this. Alright, that's a little late. I still think I cast it. Yeah, this has to be the play. To not die to a pump spell. So I get to attack with everything. And then plant. I guess I die to, like, Latinuit Helion by attacking with everything. But I do put him down to 5 life. Which is somewhat of a big deal, so yeah, I'll attack with everything. No blocks. Kills my Avacyn, but it's a prize to pay. And we pass. Hope to not die to the Latinuit Helion. And we win this. Awesome. Now, Declaration, we just want a bunch of removal. Stasis Snare, Fairgrounds Warden, Fumigate. I don't know how good Dazdan is. I mean, we really wanted it this game because he had Brawlers and Hydras, but if he has Pummelers and Servants, I guess they can have, I guess it depends on which version they play. Some of the versions, because we saw Invigorated Rampage, we know that he's, like, not the Green Belt Rampager kind of mid-range version. It's going to be the most, like, aggro version, I think. With Blossoming Defense, Rampage, some number of Uncaged Fury. So, yeah, it really kills Brawler and Hydra. Sometimes it's going to kill Cub. Doesn't kill Pummeler. I think it's probably worth keeping, like, 2... or 1, something like that. It is probably better than more cast outs. I don't think cast out is very good because it's very expensive. We can board out Selfless Spirit for sure. Although, I think sometimes they play Sweltering Suns on a sideboard. So that could be dangerous. Yeah, what about I board out some militia captains? Yeah, what if I just didn't have those cast outs at all? Then I would have like 8 ways to interact with Pummeler. 4 Warden, 2 Snares, 2 Decoction Stone. And I boarded out like 3 of those. Or is it worth the mechanic? It's possible it's worth the mechanic. I might not really need to like make a million tokens. Might not be necessary. Yeah, let's try that. I'm really not sure about how I should be sideboarding here. Alright, I'll keep this. It's a good thing that Westfall Abbey really, they have like no answer to that, so it really makes most of the matchup, like, it makes most of the matchups much less complicated, I think, and the games just will end quickly when Abby is actually good in the when it is reliable, essentially, because there's matchups where unless they have like zero cards in hand, you really don't want to do it because it's a huge liability. Inspector was a good draw. That's also a great draw. So I wonder if I just play Mechanic and I try to double block here, or do I just either crack Clue or play Mechanic? I could actually just play Mechanic and bounce Inspector, just block the Cub. If he doesn't have any energy source, it's gonna be a little annoying for him. You could have Pummeler, Brawler, Siren. There's a lot of energy sources, so I think if something, I might not even bounce the 3-bin and just double block. Yeah, let's try that. Not bounce anything and double block. That forces him to have make at least 3 energy this turn, so only like Pummeler would work, and if he spends a trick on that combat, then I'm pretty happy, especially if it's a Harness Landing, because then I just have Fairgrounds Warden. Alright, it's a Brawler, so he technically had 3 energy, but he has to spend 1 because of Hub. To make red. He's attacking. Alright, so probably has Blossoming Defense. But again, I'm happy to trade for Blossoming Defense here. Because I just get to play Fairgrounds Warden. Yep, that is perfectly fine. I wonder if I just play Monument, actually, and I don't play a Veteran's Warden, and I just get to Fumigate, and then Fingerhold's Warden, or whatever he plays after. Yeah, I kind of don't mind taking the set. Next turn I can like play Mechanic and then crack Clue. Hopefully I draw something else that I don't really care about, and I can just play it just to chump, make a one token chump, and Fumigate the following turn. Or, I mean, I guess if he doesn't play anything this turn, there's a high chance he has Harness Lightning, and then he's going to spend Harness Lightning on my Fairgrounds Warden, and then I'm actually happy playing it before my Fumigate. Oh, or I can just play Thaw Stone. Nice card. Nice top deck. We've definitely drawn pretty well in this game. Our hand was good because it had Monument and like Fumigate. I think I had Fairgrounds Warden, but it was missing like a one drop, which we drew, then lands, which we drew, then Dostan, which was perfect. Cannot deny that I've been drawing somewhat well in this league. But on the other hand, like, the deck has a lot of redraws, which is pretty sweet. Servant. So no Bristling Hydra. Still think he has at least an Harness Landing in hand. Play one of those. Can absolutely kill it with Harness Lightning. Don't really care. And I think I'd rather crack Clue than play Mechanic. I guess I could crack that main phase to just make my land drop. And now, I guess I drew the land, so I'll play a mechanic. Fair enough. Not bounce anything. And I can Dawn to bring back mechanic and 3-man inspector. And start going off. It is pretty sweet. I found that the aftermath side of Dawn is really, really good in this deck. It basically makes you never run out of gas. And the front side has been reasonably good. I like how this deck is built. Really like the main deck. I mean, sideboard, we didn't get to board in Gideon yet because we just haven't played against those decks. But I think I've liked the sideboard as well. Okay, I'll attack. It's possible it doesn't have Artist Lightning at that point and it's just like pump spells. I think it would have killed the Warden, but not necessarily true. We'll play it. Return Mechanic, Inspector. I'll play Inspector. No reason to play Mechanic here, it's just one less damage next turn if I do that. Next turn we get to Abby, which I will definitely do. Alright, so one card. I have to sack a mechanic, that's fine, I just drew it in order one. No big deal. Attack for 9. Whoa! That is messed up. Did not expect that. What the hell? Whoa. That is crazy. Alright, well, we're gonna keep Stasis Nair up in case it does that again. I guess I don't really have to because we're just gaining a bunch of life. Oh, so that was probably the card he had in hand the whole time. That would make sense. I guess I'll still keep Stasis Snare up. I don't really see a reason not to. Don't really know what could happen that kills me, but I mean, worst case, it's going to take out like a flyer that would stop me from winning. But we got there. So, yeah, as I said, I think this deck is a real contender. Like, it seems really not powerful. Super underwhelming. As you play and you don't have Monument, whenever you don't have Monument, you feel like your deck is doing nothing. Which is not false. Like, most of the cards that you play is Air. Which I think is one of the reasons I think the Handwear Militia Captain is kind of, like, necessary. It is a card that can take over the game. It never really happened, but I think it could. Even if you don't have Monument. I think Bygone Bishop is pretty sweet as well when you don't have the Monument. But when you do have Monument, this deck's really powerful. So I would definitely recommend it. And I'm going to keep playing it for sure. I don't know what cards in Hour of Devastation would add to the deck. But I'm sure there is. There's some slots that are not great. I think the cast outs are replaceable. I mean, depending on the format, maybe like the third Dos Dawn is not that good. The Aviary Mechanic are pretty good, actually.
It happened way more often than I thought that you were actually just bouncing each other. So I would definitely keep those and not play any 2-drop unless there's something really good that is spoiled in the next set. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you next week.